Hi, I'm Luciana from Holland, and today we will continue with the second part, and it will be about the ripple fill. We already did the contour fill, so this time it will be the ripple fill. Therefore, we go to circle oval, fill, ripple, and I put my spacing on 3. Left mouse click, drag, release, click again, and enter. Select and reshape. Now you see in the center there is a little pink dot. You can move the dot. For example, say to here, and you get this result. And the same you can do with the rectangle. Rectangle, fill, ripple, click and drag. If you want a nice square, you have to hold your control key down. Click and you get a really good square. Select it, duplicate and outline. So it's closed. The same you can do with this one. You can say duplicate and outline. And then the outline here also will be closed. It looks a little bit nicer. Click on it in the center or in the sequence bar, click on or select this one and go to reshape. And again, you see here, pink dot. Pick it up and move it to here or to there or just to the corner or here to the bottom. So you see how you can play with it. The stitches will follow that pink dot that I just moved. Next, I will show you a scallop, and therefore we go to digitize open shape. Right mouse click. Left mouse click, right mouse click, enter. Now you have a scallop. Select that scallop. Go to layout. And we go to circle layout. And I want 6 scallops. So over here, I choose 6. You see they are on my cursor right now. So I will hold my control key down to make a straight line. And I make sure they overlap each other a little bit. And I click on my left mouse button. And I say, you want to merge your overlapped objects? Yes. If I say no, I cannot fill it. So I have to say yes. And if I go back now to digitize, and I go back to I have to select it first. And I go to fill. This is the result. This doesn't look very nice, so I go to reshape and see if I can change that a little bit. No, the X is a little bit funny. I don't know why it happens lately. Well, this looks better. So, just if it does funny, like it did with mine, just pick up the dots and replace them, and you see it will look better. What we do now is pick up this dot. The square ones are the straight lines, and I will bring it inside. Pick up this one as well, bring it inside, and also this one. Of course, you can do it with all of them. look what will happen. Again, it acts funny. So, then this is what you get. If you now go to select, duplicate, and outline it, so you give it an outline, then the little part that was open, let me undo it again, over here, this is where it ends, the stitches, and I don't like that one, that open space here, so I duplicate it and I make an outline of the duplicate and then it will be closed. I get two stitched lines on the outside, but I don't find that a problem at all. Also, what you can do is give it another color, say for example dark green, and you get this effect. There's also another effect that I like to show you that's funny too. And we do that with digitize, closed shape, fill, and of course the ripple again. Left mouse click, right mouse click, left mouse click, right mouse click, and enter. And then we have this. What I'm going to do now again is select it, reshape, and I'm going to put this little dot outside of the pattern, like this. Now I go to select, and I go to layout. Now let me move this one a little bit out of the way. I'm going to layout, circle layout, and again, you see, not again. It's the first time I do this, I'm sorry. You see, now I have six petals, I call them. And why do I have six? Because I forgot to tell you, over here in the top, you can change it from 6 to 8 to 10. Well, let's say we will do 8 now. Now I have 8 petals. I hold my control key down to get a straight line. And I will put it right here. Do you want to merge the overlapped objects? I say no, I don't. And then I get this result. Over here you can put, of course, something like an circle or an oval. Let me choose another fill, the tatami. Like this. And enter, and it looks like this. Also, what you can do is select the whole pattern, duplicate an outline. An outline I will give another color, green color. Now the dot is underneath because it's the last thing I made over here, so I put that one. I want that one to be stitched last, so over here with the double arrows, I click on it and I will put it on top. And now it's on top. That circle also needs to be last and it will stitch last. I don't like that circle so very much, so I delete that circle. But this is how you can play with the ripple. Of course you can make, like for example, let's select this one, go to reshape. I can make it longer, like this. Also what I can do is go to select pick that one up. Ah, no. Let me duplicate it. Right mouse click, move, and I have a duplicate. Also, what I can do is go to layout, circle layout, and put it on this side. And it will be like this. Select all, duplicate, outline, and make another outline. So then you get this result, and it looks a little different, like this one. Now you see them both. Make this one a little smaller. I don't need it that wide. So now you have this result. Well, you have to be careful with the ripple that it can be where the stitches are very dense, it can be too dense and that doesn't embroider nice. So be careful with the density.